everybody, and welcome to Star Trek Model Action. White Starline 22 here, as y'all know. And today we are posting our first update on our Polar Lights 1-350 scale TOS Enterprise. I started this kit before I recorded the first intro, so I'm a little ahead. So far I've got the B and C deck glued onto the top part of the saucer, and I got that all painted up. I got my windows in along my B and C deck, and I've got my little cargo hatches in around here. I also got my bridge module done, which I don't know if you could see that or not. I'll put the camera in micro mode and just shoot some stills of this and put them at the end of the video. Yeah, so I got that little done. I got that little bit done with the little alien in the view screen. Let's see. I got a random combination of windows painted black to represent that some are turned off. And I've got my bottom saucer painted up here. Let me grab that. Here's the bottom saucer all painted up with Tamiya JN Gray. I've got it all painted up. And yeah, I need to put the windows in on this one here. And that's it. I just need to put the windows in on here. So we'll go on ahead and do that real quick. So we'll go on ahead and put our windows in here real quick. They should be dry by now. Let's just pull our instructions up here. Part number 111. Sorry, I've got to go through all of these and look and see what's what. Part number 111, 113, 118, 110, 101. Well, Lord have mercy, where is it? Watch it be on the sprue there that I have not had painted yet. Yep. But that's fine, there just simply won't be any windows here. So we're going to go and clip it off. Get over there. I'm going to go through here and clip it off. And now we've got our window inserts for this. So I'm going to move the instructions out the way. They can go back down here on the floor. I just needed to see the part number. Let's see here. That's shown by this peg, so they should go right in there. What is it for? Oh, this one's for this side. Okay, this, no big deal. That's no big deal. Simple mix up of parts. Alright, so now that I know where that goes, I'm going to take my tester's just regular tube glue, and I'm going to take and put a nice bead around where the window is going, the window post, whatever you want to call it, just enough for it to stick. Set that right there, and then I'm just gonna slide the windows right in. Just gonna slide them right in there and press them down into place. And now we've got, I don't know if you can see that, but now we've got windows. And we'll move on to the next row, which is part number 119. I know I have it. Right here. Yep. And that goes right here in the front. So we're just going to take our tester's glue again. Put the cap out the way. We're just going to put a little bit there. And set that back over there. Press it down in there. And now we've got our front windows. We've got our windows in the front. So now we're going to turn it over here to this side. And we're going to repeat the process that we did on the 112. I know I have a part for 112. Alright. I know where this part here goes. So we're just going to go on ahead and some of these there. You can tell where they go by just simply looking at the holes on the model. Some of them there, you actually have to refer to the instructions. But most of them, you should be able to tell without just by looking at the holes on the model. Let's see. Well, apparently, yeah, there they go. Just had to wiggle it around a little bit, but they fit down in there. And see, they give you a nice effect that some of them are lit and some are not. Now we move on to the opposite side, which is, again, the same. You just pop in the windows. Snap, they don't go right there. So I've got these two right here to put in on this one, and this little window right here to put in. Alright, so this time I'm just going to take and put the glue around inside the model, just for time's sake, to go faster. I'm just going to put the little glue inside of here, and just drop these in place. I mean, you know, don't get any harder than that. Apply and drop. That's how this kit was engineered to do. Which is good on Polar Light's part. They did a great job with this. And the other side, same thing. Line it up in the holes. Alright, now get in there. And drop in place. Take the hobby knife and just kind of push it on down in there. And then this last little window. Where did my right here in the back, we take and lower it into place as well. And then now those little windows are in place. I just shoved my fingers in glue. Oh well, at least it's on the bottom and not on the top. At least it's on in this side and not. And you know what I mean. Alright, so. Yeah, they got those messed up. On this area right here, these windows right here and right here, the part numbers are reversed. It should be 112 over here and 111 over here. Because if I can find the other part, there's like three sheets of white up. I bet it's on this one here. 112, yep. On the sheet that hasn't been painted yet. Oh well. Let me just see. Just to confirm this, I don't want to mess you guys up. Oh, yep. Numbers are backwards. Okay, so on these numbers right here, on these windows right here, the part numbers on the instructions are wrong. This one right here is numbered 112 on the instructions. It should be 111, and then the other one should be 112, where it should be 111 when it's supposed to be 112. Okay, so I got that done. Yep. All right, just add some glue. It's glued. Put the window in. I believe this could be my favorite part of doing this model, is putting in these windows. Oh, got it in the wrong way, that's why. Hey, you know, sometimes you make mistakes, can't do nothing about it. It's no big deal, though. No big deal. You know, just. Then this window goes over here on this side. Like I said, some of these windows you can tell where they go, some you can't. You win some, you lose some. Yep, that goes there. Let me snip this one off. I don't like how that's tall. I just don't like how that's tall. Spin it around. So yeah, that window is glued in now. Now we only have one, two, three. We only have three more sets to glue in, and then we'll be done with the bottom half of this hole. We'll be done, and when I go back and do my touch-up paint work, actually, we'll probably seal this up tonight. We'll probably seal up the saucer tonight. So yeah, we'll get this window glued in, and then we'll seal up the secondary hole. We'll seal up this. I'll put in my last final touches, but I'll do that off camera. And then we will come back, and the next time you see this, we will have this all sealed up. So let's put these last few windows in here together, and then I'll let y'all take a break for a half a second as I time warp this. It'll appear as a time warp to y'all, but it won't to me. Let's see here. Yes, this one goes right here when I move this out the way. Let's just drop this in and see. Yeah. don't know. Why ain't you snapping down in there? You don't accidentally go right here. That's just... I know you don't. Oh, well, that might have something to do with it. That and the... incompetent lack of determination and skill. Yep, you just had to get it to lay down in there. Now the problem is getting it to come out so I can put blue in it. There it is. Let's put the glue in here. Going ahead and glue this all up. And then we will glue. Alright, so as long as it pops down in there fine. Oh, so none of this is actually getting wet by the glue, I can see. It's gonna be hard. Well, some of it is. Some of it's getting touched by glue. I'll be fine. Alright, so that's it. Now we got one more window thing to go. So we'll just rotate it around here. And I do believe it's going to be this one. Yep. Let's just put some glue in here. Yeah, smear it around. Blah, blah, blah. Blah, blah, blah. Smear the glue around. Yeah, there we go. And now we just drop our window in. This window goes here, line it up in the holes, and drop in place. It's that simple. Alright guys, so I'm going to go on ahead and get the saucer sealed up here. I'm going to put in my navigation beacons here real quick, and then I'm going to go on ahead and get this all sealed up. So we're going to take a... So, yeah, we'll catch up with you in a few minutes. Okay, guys, and we're back with a little... Okay, guys, and we're back here. We've got our saucer glued together. I've still got the tape on it because it's drying. And I'm going to be masking this off in a little bit there for some touch-up paint work. Isn't it already looking better with that saucer on? You can look through the top there and see the bridge nicely done. It's just nice. It looks very, very good. I've got the tape on there to hold it down and close up the gap. Ain't much gap on here, so I don't know why I got the tape there, but, you know. Next, in the next update, we're going to be starting work. We're going to put our bridge dome on. We're going to paint our little marker lights here. And we're going to install the impulse engine. And then we're going to start working on the nacelle pylons and the neck, and if we have time, we're even going to get started on the engineering section. So check back with us, and let's see, today's January the 1st. And we'll check back with us there Saturday, and we should have an update for you. As we say all the time here on Star Trek Model Action, live long and prosper, and happy modeling, guys. We'll catch you next time.